Grace, mercy, and peace be multiplied unto each of you from the God and Father of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Listen, we are very excited today as we celebrate the Lord's Supper today. We want you to come one and come all and journey with us in our new sermon series in the book of Jonah. Make sure that you have your sacraments ready, and we're going to ask you to join in song of sweet accord with my darling wife, Melissa, as she leads us in our hymn this morning, How Great is Our God.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? Oh, we'll see how great is our God. Age to age he stands, and time is in his hands. Beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The Godhead three in one, Father, Spirit, and Son. The Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? All will see how great is our God. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? Oh, we'll see how great is our God. You're the name above all names. You are worthy of our praise, and my heart will sing, how great is our God. You're the name above all names. You are worthy of our praise, and my heart will sing, how great is our God. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? Oh, we'll see how great is our God. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, we'll see how great is our God.
Again, I want to thank my darling wife, Melissa, for leading us in such an awesome hymn of the church, How Great is Our God. Certainly, we serve a great God doing not, beloved. Will you grab your copy of God's word? I'm eager, amen, to get down to scripture, amen. I want to read the word of prayer. I want to read scripture into your hearing, amen. And I want to, amen, explain the text from you, amen, concerning what we will find here in Jonah chapter 1. Let us bow. Lord God and our Christ, to you be the glory as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God, now we pray that you open the eyes of our understanding. May we behold the wonderful truth of your scripture. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Melt us and mold us and use us and fill us. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Help us, O God, to learn of your will and your way, that we might not be hearers of your word only, but doers, O God. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. Again, beloved, join me there in Jonah, chapter number 1, beginning at the very first verse, and I will deal today with verses 1 through 6. I will be in the English Standard Version of the Bible. That is the version we use here at the Turkey Creek Church. Now, the word of the Lord came to Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, "Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and call out against it, for their evil has come up before me." But Jonah rose to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa and found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare and he went down into it to go with them to Tarshish away from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord hurled a great wind upon the sea, and there was a mighty tempest on the sea, so that the ship threatened to break up. Then the mariners were afraid. Each cried out to his God, and they hurled the cargo that was in the ship, amen, into the sea to lighten it for them. But Jonah had gone down into the inner part of the ship and had lain down and was fast asleep. So the captain came and said to him, "What do you mean, you sleeper? Arise and call out to your God. Perhaps the God will give a thought to us that we may not perish. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God shall stand forever." Beloved, as we begin this new sermonic series entitled A Witness on the Run, amen, we will walk together hand in hand through the book and the life of Jonah. But today specifically, I want to talk to you from this theological thought and this homiletical headline as we consider a witness on a run. I want to talk about running from God. Running from God. And predicated upon our text of study, I want to argue 4 points today. I want to argue that God is so close that you can't get away from him. I want to argue today that when you try to run from God, you will always run into God. Amen. I want to let you know today, amen, that doing wrong in the rightest way does not make running from God right. Amen. And the 4th point I want to argue today, amen, is that you and I need to stay vigilant and don't run from God. Will you take my hand, be my friend, and consider point number 1 with me? Amen. I want to, amen, talk about that God is so close to you, amen, that you can't get away from him. I said God is so close to you that you cannot get away from him. Child of God, God is so close to us, amen, that we can't get away from him. In other words, he's near to you and he's near to me today. And I don't know, amen, what you're facing right now, but one thing is for sure, amen, is that God is right beside you. Can I get a witness right here? Amen. And because God is omniscient, he knows what's going on in your existential reality. Amen. In other words, child, he's not a do-nothing God. Amen. Notice Jonah here in verse number 3. Can't you see him in your Bible? Amen. He's acting like you and I, amen, at times because Jonah tried to run from God, did he not? Beloved, Jonah was a prophet, amen. He was a man whose job was to carry the word of God, the truth of God, to people who needed to hear it, amen. But when God told Jonah to go to the Ninevites, Israel's cruel enemies, amen, people, amen, that they had race relation problems with, amen, Jonah didn't want nothing to do with it, amen. So what did Jonah do? He tries to run from God, but is there anybody listening and watching today who knows that God is so close to you, amen, that you can't get away from him? Oh, shucks, in here, I thought I could get a witness today, but thank God I brought my own. I heard David say in Psalm 139, verse 7 through 10, particularly in the English Standard Version, where shall I go from your spirit, amen? Or where shall I flee from your presence, amen? If I ascend to heaven, amen, you are there, amen. If I make my bed in hell, you are there. If I take the wings, amen, of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me and your right hand shall hold me. Beloved, not only is God so close to you that you can't get away from him, the next thing we see in the text, amen, and the text suggests this to us, amen, is that when we try to run from God, we will always run into God. Yes, beloved, when you try to run from God, you will always run into God. Will you walk around verse number 3 with me? But Jonah rose to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa. He found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare and he went down into it to go with them to Tarshish away from the presence of the Lord. Child of God, here in verse number 3, Jonah basically said no to God and he bought a ticket to go to Tarshish in the opposite direction that God had told him to go. Can I ask you a question? Are you headed in the opposite direction from where God is telling you to go? Are you headed in the opposite direction, amen, from what God is asking you to do? In other words, that person or that group, amen, you're trying to impress or be around, and God said go the other way. In other words, amen, the way that you're treating somebody, that thing that God wants you to do, amen, that thing that God wants you to give up or flee from, amen. Beloved, are you headed, amen, in the opposite direction from God? You see, I submit to you today, amen, that you better do what God says before it's everlasting too late. Notice Jonah in verse number 3, if you will. You see, Jonah thought, amen, he had run away from God. Amen, but Jonah forgot something, y'all. Beloved, Jonah forgot the same thing that I forget and you forget when we try to run from God. Can I tell you what it is? Amen, Jonah forgot, amen, that you can't run from God without running through God and riding up running towards God. In the Lord, all right, today. Amen, we see also here that verse number 3 teaches us, amen, that Jonah, amen, got on that ship. But it's verse number 4 that shows us specifically and teaches us, amen, that God, amen, was able to take care of that problem because God ordered the sea to track Jonah down. If I was, amen, in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, where I grew up, amen, the boys on the street would say that he got slow walked down, amen. But notice in verse number 4, amen, how through God's ordering, a fierce storm erupted on the sea to the point that innocent people were about to be harmed physically, all because Jonah was disobedient, was he not? Child of God, notice in verse number 4, notice the imagery in the text. Notice how God had ordered the waves to rise up so high, amen, that the waves literally began to point a finger and point out Jonah. Amen. Child of God, instead of Jonah, amen, running from God, Jonah should have been singing, send me, I'll go. Send me, I'll go. I'll go if I have to go by myself. But can I ask you another question? How do you handle it? Amen. When what God has asked, called, or commissioned you to do is uncomfortable to you. How do you handle that, beloved? Beloved, Jonah had race relations problems. Amen. Just like what's going on in the midst of this pandemic peril and pandemonium right here in America right now. So the question becomes, how do you handle it, child of God, when God is sending you to people who do not like you? And as a matter of fact, you might not necessarily be too fond of them either. How do you handle that, beloved? Can I tell you how you should handle it? Amen. You do what God had asked you to do. Amen. And you do it from a place of love in your heart. I heard God say in Matthew chapter 22, amen, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the great and first commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbors as yourselves. Can I wrap this thing tight? Make it light and put a handle so you can tote it with you today. Beloved, you got to do what God says out of your love for God. You see, you can't do it in your own power, amen, but because of his great love, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And when you love, amen, your love for God is right, your love for your neighbor will be right. I thought I could get another witness, but I brought another one just in case. In 1 John chapter 4, amen, verses 20 through 21, the Bible says, if anyone says, I love God and hates his brother, he is a liar. That's what the Bible says. Amen. For he who does not love, amen, his brother, amen, whom he, amen, can see, cannot love God and whom he cannot see. And this commandment we have from him, whoever loves God must love his brother also. Not only is God so close to you and I, beloved, that we can't get away from him. Not only when you try to run from God, you will always run into God. But the third point I see in this text, amen, is that doing wrong in the rightest way does not make running from God right. Doing wrong in the rightest way does not make running from God right. Will you walk around verse number 5 with me? Then the mariners were afraid. Each cried out to his God, and they hurled the cargo that was in the ship into the sea to lighten it for them. But Jonah had gone down into the inner part of the ship and had lain down and was fast asleep. Notice with me here in verse number 5, amen, that while the ship sailed smoothly over the sea, Jonah forgot about his God, did he not? As a matter of fact, you could not have distinguished Jonah from anyone else, including those who were not saved on board. Can I tell you why today? Amen. It is because through Jonah's disobedience, he was just as bad as they were. Notice back in verse number 3 with me how Jonah began doing wrong in the rightest way that he could. The Bible says, so he paid the fare and went down into it to go with them to Tarshish away from the presence of the Lord. So here in verse number 5, as Jonah was chilling out in the inner part of the ship, Jonah might have thought, I can go to Tarshish if I want to. I paid my fare. I'm not breaking and entering, or I'm not a stowaway. In other words, Jonah was not trespassing because he paid his fare. But like many of us, he was relying upon his own intuition, his own ability, amen, which was taking him in a totally different direction from where God had told him to go. What are you saying, Brother Pastor? Oh, I'm so glad you asked. Child of God, our excuses and rationalization for disobedience are mere hiding places for lies. In other words, child of God, trying to do wrong in the rightest way in which things can be done does not make it right. Let me press rewind right there. Trying to do a wrong thing in the rightest way in which it can be done does not make it right. If you and I go contrary to the Lord's will, even though you and I do it in the most decent and perhaps in the most devout manner, it is still sinful and it will bring you and I under the, amen, the judgment and condemnation of God. Not only Is God so close to you and I that we can't get away from him? Not only when you try to run from God, you will always run into God. Not only is doing wrong in the rightest way not making running from God right, next and finally, just let me hit it one time. Amen. You must stay vigilant and don't run from God. Walk around verse number 6 with me. So the captain came and said to him, "What do you mean, you sleeper? Arise, call out to your God. Perhaps the God will give a thought to us that we may not perish." Notice in verse number 6 here, how running from God caused Jonah not to be vigilant, watchful, or awake. He became like most of us, comfortable in his sin, in his rebellion, and in his disobedience. How do I know? Because Jonah was asleep in the midst of all the confusion that was going on in verse number 4 and 5. And child of God, you and I have to be sure. We have to be very sure we are doing God's will for our lives without hesitation or even reservation. You see, amen, you and I must be vigilant and not run from God, lest we become blinded with sleep to all that is going on, amen, in this world all about us. In other words, for you and I to be negligent of God's work in such a time as this pandemic, this peril, and this pandemonium is simply running from God. The devil alone, all by himself, is making enough noise to wake up all the Jonas in whatever ship we might be in if we only want to be awake. So, child of God, there is tumult and storms all around us, are they not? Storms of messed up matrimony. Amen. Storms of misplaced values. Amen. And misguided feet. Oh, yes, there are storms of lunatic leadership all around us. There are storms of rage in relationships, storms of the disadvantages of life, storms of wrath, of anger, of hatred, and yes, even malice. Yet some profession Christians are just like Jonah in the text. They're asleep in the inner part of the ship. Some profession Christians, amen, they shout and they jump high on Sunday, but they're asleep on Monday through Saturday. Some profession Christians, amen, are able to speak in tongues and give their tithes on time, but they turn their backs, amen, on their fellow man, and they're asleep, y'all. Some profession Christians, amen, are more concerned with about getting people in a church building during a pandemic instead of getting the church to the people. They're asleep, y'all. It does not matter how high we can jump and shout on Sunday. What matters to God is how, amen, straight we can run Monday, amen, through the next Sunday. Isn't the Lord all right today? And I don't know about you in the room today, amen, but I know that, amen, that if God has call you to it. Oh, yes, amen. You better pick your feet up because I'm going home now. Amen. He is able. Yes, he is to bring you through it. Can I tell you how I know? Amen. I've seen, oh, yes, the lightning flashing. Amen. I heard the thunder roll. Yes, I felt sin's breakers dashing during this pandemic, trying to conquer my soul. But I heard, yes, I did. I heard the voice of Jesus bidding you, Williams, amen, tell them to keep on fighting on because he promised never to leave us. Oh, yes, and here, never to leave us alone. Amen. During this pandemic, the world's fierce winds are blowing. Amen. Temptations are sharp and keen. Amen. But I don't know about you. I feel a peace in knowing, amen, that my Savior, yes, he does. He stands between. Amen. He stands to shield me from danger when earthly friends are gone. Can I tell y'all something? Oh, shucks in here. He promised. Yes, he did. He promised never to leave me alone. Amen. When affliction's valley, amen, amen, I'm treading a road of care. My Savior helps me to carry my cross when it's heavy to bear. My feet entangled with briars, amen, ready to cast me down, amen. My Savior has whispered that he promised, amen. He promised, yes, he did, never to leave me alone. Can I tell you, he died? I say, didn't he die? He died! Didn't he die? He died, amen, on the mountain, amen. For me, they pierced his side. For me, he opened that fountain, that crimson, cleansing time. For me, yes, Lord. For me, he waiteth in glory. Amen. He's seated upon his throne. Can I tell y'all something? He promised. Oh, something here. Yes, he did. He promised never to leave me alone. Y'all know him, don't you? Born in Bethlehem, reared in Nazareth, ministered in Jerusalem, crucified and died on Calvary. I said, didn't he die? Didn't he die? He died. Yes, he did, but he didn't stay dead. He was hanging. Oh, something here on the third day morning. He got up with all power. Beloved, you don't have to run from God. But I double dog dare you. I triple dog dare you to hasten to his throne. God so loved you that he gave his only begotten son, and his son Jesus gave his life. Listen, while you and I were yet sinners, Jesus Christ died for us. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? That'll chase you down to Savior and then turn around and bless you. For God so loved you that Jesus died for your sins. And he rose and he ascended up to heaven and he's seated at the right hand of the Father. And he is coming back again. Will you be ready? If you have never accepted him as your Lord and Savior, you can be ready today by praying the prayer of salvation with you. Will you pray with me right now this prayer of salvation? And when you pray this prayer, you will be truly saved and you can be no more unsaved than water can fall out of the well if you confess with your mouth and you believe in your heart. Let us pray. Father, I've sinned against you in my thoughts, in my words, and in my deeds. By what I've done, by what I've left undone. I've not loved you with my whole heart. I am truly sorry. And I humbly repent. Please forgive me of my sins. Please save my soul. I confess with my mouth and I believe in my heart that you suffered, bled, and died for me. You rose and you're coming back again. Please come into my life. Thank you for saving my soul. I am saved. I am truly saved. Hallelujah. I'm yours, Lord. Amen. Beloved, if you prayed that prayer, you can be no more unsaved and water can fall out of the well. Your next steps is for you to log on to www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org. Please fill out the contact us link at the bottom of that page, or you may dial 478-272-9169. We want to hear from you, amen, so that we can help you grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior. Listen, we would love for you to unite with us as your church family. I would love to be your pastor, but perhaps there might be some other ministry that you want us to send us to. Listen, we'll call that ministry, connect with them, and send you on your way. But again, we would love to be your church membership. I would love to be your pastor. Please log on to www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org. Click on the Contact Us section at the bottom and fill out the information. Or you may call 478-272-9169. That rings right on my desk. You can leave a message if I'm not there, and I'll be getting back with you. Maybe you're out there and you've been running from God. You've been trying to do it your own way. You've been struggling. You've been straining as you're on your way home, trying to figure life out, trying to do it by yourself to no avail. If you would pray with me, and we will ask God for peace, power, and provision. Let us bow. Father God, we come to you now for you to give us peace that passeth all understanding, for you to give us power to walk right, talk right, do right, live right, according to your will. Oh God, that you would also, oh God, just give us protection as we go throughout this life. Father God, we need your provision daily. Forgive us where we have fell short of your glory. Forgive us the times where we went in our own direction. Oh God, pick us up and turn us around. Please place our feet on solid ground, the solid rock of Christ. God, just give us the power and God, just give us the discernment, oh God, and the want to do your will. Forgive us of our sins, creating us a clean heart and renewing us a right spirit. Oh God, let the bones that you have crushed rejoice. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. Listen, if you prayed that prayer, your next step is for us to go disciple you and for you to go through our discipleship process. Listen, I would love for you to log on to www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org. Amen. So you can participate in some of our sessions to help you grow as a mature believer. Listen, again, that's www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org. Amen. Click on the Contact Us link. Let us know your decision today, or you may call 478-272-9169. At this time, we're going to ask that you make ready, amen, for the Lord's table. Beloved, as you get your sacraments, as we come to the Lord's table today, one with another, and commune with one another, commune with our God, let us sing, let us break bread together as you prepare your sacraments, and we pray God's blessing upon your bread and your wine. Amen. Let us
bread together on our knees,
on our knees.
Let us bread together on our knees.
On our knees.
When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me.
Let us drink wine.
Let us drink wine together on our knees.
Yes, on our knees.
Let us drink wine together on our knees.
Yes, on our knees.
When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me.
Beloved, on the night that our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ was betrayed, he took the bread. He said, "This is my body, which is given for you. As often as you eat this bread, you do show forth the Lord's death until he shall come again." And he break the bread. In the same manner, after supper, he took the cup. He said, "This cup is into my new covenant, the blood, which is shared for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." He says that often as you drink this cup, ye do show forth my death until I shall come again. The old preacher would say, "As freely as you see this being poured from one vessel to another, as freely as the Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ shed his blood for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins." As you distribute your sacraments, we're going to sing a small portion of this hymn, "I Know It Was the Blood."
I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost,
Jesus,
he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me.
The body of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, the giver, the sustainer of everlasting life. Let us all eat together. The blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the giver, the sustainer, and preserver of everlasting life. Let us all drink together. After they ate the bread and they drank the cup, they sang a hymn and they went out into the Mount of Olives. We know that we don't have a Mount of Olives to go out into, but we do have a mean, cruel world that's full of peril, pandemic, and pandemonium. I want to sing a portion of the hymn. Guide me, O thou great Jehovah, pilgrim through this barren land. Thank you, Lord, for I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Guide me, O thou great Jehovah, pilgrim through this barren land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. I am weak, but thou art mighty. I need you to hold me with thy powerful hand. Why don't you lift your voice, bread of heaven? Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. To raise your voice right where you are.
I love Jesus.
Come on and lift your voice. Let heaven hear you.
I love Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I do.
Come on, lift it up real high this time.
I love Jesus.
Come on and praise him, saying,
I love Jesus.
Come on, say it like you're thanking him right now.
I love Jesus.
Yes, I do. Thank you so kindly, beloved. At this time, let us turn to Devonna for our announcement.
Greetings from the news desk here at Turkey Creek Missionary Baptist Church, where Dr. Frederick C. Williams is our pastor. My name is Devonna Watson, and I'm here to bring you this week's news from the Creek. Monday prayer line will be at 7 a.m. and 9 p.m. The toll-free number is 1-302-202-1110. The conference code is 777-581. And now, let's take a look at this week's prayer request.
This week's prayer request, we have Annie L. Lowry, Osnola Davis, Mother Christine Baker, Hattie Thomas, Marie Smith, Martha Farmer, Bobby Edmond, Lucille Collins, Latrell Roach, Joyce Tyson Williams, all P-12 and college students, Shirley Baker, Vaughn London, Pat Rooks, Victoria Wright, Rosa Lee Simmons, Deacon Henry Lane, McKinley Williams, Martha Ross, Wilbert Roberts, Ella Lee Way, Mary Edmond, Brittany Paldo, Stevie Ward, James Cartwright, Carla Cartwright, Judith Celestine Lynch, Kaylin Lynch, Mervyn Adderley, Keisha Lance Bottoms, Deacon Richard Hunter, Reverend Ernest Holmes, and the Lloyd family.
And now for this week's birthdays.
This week's birthdays, we have Reverend Johnny Baker, August 3rd. McKinley Williams, August 4th. Nevaeh Young, August 5th. Taylor Wright, August 6th. Mullins McLeod, August 6th. And Alan Baker, August 7th.
Thank you for your kindness, generosity, and stewardship of the financial resources that God has blessed you with. There are three ways to send your tithes and offerings to Turkey Creek. You may mail them to the attention of Catherine Smith at 1164 Willie Wood Road, East Dublin, Georgia, 31027. You may also use the Cash App by using our cash tag, $TCMBC828. Again, that is the $TCMBC828. You may log on to our secure website at www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org. Click on the secure given link and follow the easy instructions. Thank you again for being obedient to God in your giving.
Here's a spiritual challenge for you. Will you commit to praying for the salvation of one lost person and seek opportunities to share the gospel with him or her? It can be a friend, relative, co-worker, classmate, or acquaintance. It can even be an enemy. After all, Jesus did tell us to love our enemies and pray for those who persecute us in Matthew chapter 5, verse 44. Pray and invest in one person the Lord places on your heart that needs Christ. Make a commitment today. Identify your one. Begin praying daily for your one and seeking opportunities to tell them about Jesus and invite them to church.
Have your finances been causing you to lose sleep or lack of peace in your life? Do you have more month than money? Do you want to get your financial house in order? Do you want to leave a legacy for your children? Join Dr. Marion Brown and Pastor Williams every Wednesday night, beginning in August at 6:30 p.m. for the Financial Peace University. This life-changing Bible study is by Dave Ramsey. Please email us to register at turkeycreekb@gmail.com.
Today, August 2nd, is Holy Communion Sunday. On this day, we remember the Last Supper Jesus had with his disciples. Although we cannot be together physically at the moment, we can still come together spiritually in remembrance of him and all that he has done. On August the 11th, it's our time to shine. Be sure to get out to the polls and vote. Make sure that your voice is heard because your opinion and thoughts matter. That's Tuesday, August the 11th. Go vote. This has been your weekly news from the Creek. My name is Devonna Watson, and I hope to see you all next Sunday. Have a blessed day.
The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee. The Lord lift his countenance upon you, be gracious unto you, and give you peace. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Beloved, we love you, and there's nothing you can do about it.